Good morning, students. I hope everyone is safe at home. So, before starting the lesson, I want to wish all of you, wish you all a very and prosperous, happy Bhogi and Makar Sankranti. So, enjoy as well as concentrate on your studies. So, in the previous class, we discussed about the how the digestion occurs in the stomach. So today we are going to discuss about how the digestion takes place in the intestine. So how the muscular system and nervous system helps for the digestion of the food. So what is our lesson today? Coordination. In life processes. As well as the reverse peristalsis. So today we are going to discuss about the action of acid on the walls of the stomach. For that we will conduct an experiment. Just you take two leaves. I think I explained this one again. I am going to explain. Take two leaves. Okay. This just you take two leaves. For one leaf, we apply the Vaseline. For one leaf, we apply the Vaseline, or you can take any grease or oil on both sides. And the other leaf, you leave it like that. And take the diluted hydrochloric acid and put one drop on both the leaves. And observe for 1 or 2 minutes. You observe that the leaf on which the Vaseline coat is not there, it shrinks. So it will become like this. It will become like this. And the rest to which the Vaseline is applied, it will be remain same. So we can complete this experiment with the stomach. The walls of the stomach is lined with the mucous membrane. So this mucous membrane contains mucous glands. This mucus gland is a juice, this mucus. So this mucus is very slimy and protects the walls of the stomach by the from the action of this hydrochloric acid. So now we'll move to small intestine. So when you move before going to the small intestine, we'll discuss about, you see, this is the stomach, you know that? And what is this? This is the duodenum, and you see we have this many. Okay, so if you see small intestine, the small intestine is divided into 3 parts. It contains 3 parts. They are, the first one is duodenum. Duodenum. The second one, jejunum. Jejunum means the coiled part, and ileum. These are the 3 parts of the small intestine. So approximately the length of the small intestine is 6.7 meters. 6.7 meters. So you see this U-shaped structure is called duodenum. And this structure, the coil structure is called jejunum. And the part of the small intestine attached to the large intestine, this part is called as ileum. Okay, so now we conduct an experiment. See, the experiment, just you take 2 papers. Just one is 10 into 20 centimeters, and the other is 20 into 20 centimeters. And just you make the tube. Just you make the tube and try to insert this big tube into the small tube. Can you insert it? Once you try. The same thing what you do, just you take this larger one and make it into folds. Just what you into folds like this. Like this we have to fold. So if you like this, if you fold easily, you see like this you fold. If you fold like this easily, you can insert this larger tube into the smaller one. In the same way, in our abdominal cavity also, this the small intestine contains so many finger-like structures. You see this finger-like structures. These finger-like structures are called as villi. They are called as villi, and they are called as villi. Villus means singular, villi means plural. So if you see the structure of the villi, contains epithelial tissue. It contains a layer of epithelial tissue. This is the epithelial tissue. Then also it can be supplied with large number of blood capillaries. Why is blood capillaries? You know that the digestion will be completed with a small intestine, and the simpler molecules like carbohydrates, glucose, amino acids, fatty acids will be absorbed and entered into the blood. And also it contains large number of, you know that this is the mucous membrane, slimes contains, it produces more mucus. If you see this intestinal tubes, they are very slimy. You want, I think so. You can understand by telling the body, and if you see that one, the tubes are very slimy. Why? Because it produces a large amount of mucus for the easy lubrication of food. Okay, then it also contains lacteal. Lacteal means a part of the lymphatic system. This is the part of the lymphatic system. So the waste material from this one be added to the venous system, to this lymphatic system. Once you know, remember lymphatic system, so it will be connected here. So this is the epithelial tissue, epithelium, and the blood vessels, blood capillaries. And this is the mucous membrane. This is the lacteal. So this is your 2 marks question. You will get this one for the 2 marks. So here you see this is jejunum. Jejunum is a coiled part of the intestine. So it contains mostly this villi. This is called also microvilli. Also they have the finger-like structure. So if you see this structure, you see the structure here. So it contains epithelium and also network of blood capillaries, mucous membranes, mucous glands, and lacteal. These are the parts. If you write these parts like this, you will get 2 marks. Okay, only they'll ask to draw the diagram and they'll ask you what is the importance of the villi.
So the importance, what is the importance here? The absorption takes place, the digestion food which is comes into this villi. Here the digestion occurs as well as the absorption also takes place, and the undigested food will be passed to the large intestine. So here muscles plays an important role. Here the muscular system plays an important role. So if you see these muscles, muscular system as well as nervous system, they plays an important for the movement of the food, digestion of the food, for the movement of the food. So this movement of the food is called as propulsion. Okay, for the movement of the food, for the digestion, for absorption, and fourth one, for expelling. So in all these
plays. The muscular system as well as nervous system plays an important role. So here, if you see this intestine, the intestine is a unique system to be present as compared to the other organs. Okay? So when you compare to other organs, so the intestine will get a specialized nervous system. So that is called as enteric nervous system. That is called as enteric nervous system. Regarding this enteric nervous system, we will discuss in the next class. This enteric nervous system is a very important question mark, and the structure of illness also very important.